Hello dear students, in last video we have seen what exactly lock based protocols are. In that we have seen two modes of lock, that the lock can be work in two modes, either in shared mode or in exclusive mode. Then how these locks are used in concurrency control, that we have seen. In what situation the locks are granted, that also we have seen. Now we'll see one example. Let A and B be two accounts that are accessed by transactions T1 and T2. The transaction T1 transfers $50 from account B to account A. The transaction T2 displays the total amount of money in account A and B, that is sum of A and B. So let us see what are the different statements, or how we can log different items in transaction T1. So left figure indicates the transaction T1. In transaction T1, first of all we have to log the data item of account B. So log X B. X is nothing but exclusive mode. So the B account is locked in exclusive mode because exclusive mode allows us to read and write the data. As we are transferring money from account B to A, we have to deduct $50 from account B, and then the updated value has to be stored in the database. That's why we use lock in exclusive mode. So lock XB, then we have to read the value in the database, so read B. Then B will be deducted by $50, so B is equal to B minus 50, and after deduction what will be the value of account B, that will be updated in the database with write statement. So in this way, lock XB, read B, B is equal to B minus 50, write B statements are there. After transferring money and updating the database, we have to unlock the account B. Then these 50 rupees has to be transferred to account A. So lock X A, that means A account has to be locked in exclusive manner. Then read statement, then A is equal to A plus 50, that means the account $50 are transferred from B account to A account. So A account is updated with $50. Then whatever values of A are updated, that has to be stored in the database. So write A statement is used, and after that we have to unlock data item, or we have to unlock the transaction which is used for A. So this is how T1 transaction works. Then next transaction is T2. What T2 is doing? T2 is just displaying the addition of both the accounts. So as in addition we don't need to write, or we don't need to change the values of the account, we don't have to use here exclusive lock. We are just reading the value in A account, then we are reading the value in B account, and we are just displaying the addition of A and B. So in this way we are not using exclusive mode clock. So in T2 transaction, account A is locked in shared mode. Then we have to read the value in account A, then unlock A. Similarly, lock S B, read B, unlock B, and finally we are going to display the addition of A and B. So this is how different modes of lock works. Now suppose that the value of accounts A and B are $100 and $200 respectively. So in A account we have $100 and in B account we have $200. If these two transactions are executed serially, either in order T1 T2 or in order T2 T1, then transaction T2 will display the value as $300, that is addition of account A and account B. But the condition is that after execution, entire execution of T1, T2 will be executed, or T2 T2 will be executed before T1, but this should be serial. However, if these transactions are executed concurrently, that means simultaneously, so we cannot say that T1 transaction will complete and then T2 will start. In concurrent execution, while T1 will start and in between, before completion of T1, T2 may start its execution. So, the schedule 1 as shown in the diagram is possible. In this case, transaction T2 displays $250, which is incorrect. Let us see, first T1 will be executed, so it will lock the account B, that is we have 200 rupees in account B. Then read B is equal to B minus 50. So B minus 50 will be 200 minus 50 is equal to 150. We have updated the database, so B account has now 150. We have unlocked the account, then T2 transaction will get executed. Lock SA, read A. Read A means we read $100 value. Unlock A, then lock B. So what is the new value of B now? Already we have deducted $50 from B account. So in B value, we have $150. So read B means we have read the value as 150. Then display A plus B. So what value of A plus B will be displayed? B is 150 and A is 100. So 100 plus 150 is 250. And then T1 again starts executing. So log XA, read A, A is equal to A plus 50. But what is the value of A? Value of A is 100. And 150 is equal to 150. And then write A. So A value will be 150. But it is wrong value. So if the transactions get executed serially, it may give us different result, and if they executed parallelly or concurrently, or if the execution of transactions are serially, then we get the correct result. But in concurrent execution, the database or the values are inconsistent. So these are some of the flaws of serial execution, and if there is a concurrent execution, the values in the database may be inconsistent due to this type of scenario.